Hi there, everybody. My name is Jackson Tyler, and I'm doing a silly voice. I don't know why. It's kind of similar to my normal voice, but just ridiculous. Hi. This is LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Welcome to this Let's Play. I'm chatting about LEGO Star Wars, and I'm going along watching the movies as I go. Let's go in here. Let's play Gunship Cavalry. I'll just let this scroll play for you. This whole the original version of this was more bearable. It was still a bad level, but it was at least not what this was, which is total trash. Can't go through. Shoot everything, shoot everyone. Oh, this has tow cables. Oh, I hate everything. Oh, the tow cables though. I have to tow it all the way to, I assume, those things. I have to do it twice, great. That was just quality driving from me. I missed. These vehicle levels are atrocious. Good. One. I don't care. I don't have any money to loot. Oh, fine. I'll go get the money that's there, because that's decent money at least. You're not going to pick up the blue one. Now, that would be helpful. This scene in the movie, this whole ending is one of the most boring final acts in anything ever, which is in contrast to The Phantom Menace, whose final act was relatively like competent. It was a payoff to a bunch of stuff it hadn't earned, because the movie itself was bad, none of the arcs were earned, and you didn't really care about any of the characters. But as a final act, it was fine. It was like, okay, so the Jedi fight Darth Maul. I really need to be careful about that, don't I? Yeah. Come on. Yeah, the Jedi fight Darth Maul, Anakin's up in the sky, Padme and everyone are breaking into the palace, and the Gungans are fighting the droid army. It's clear there's a character at every location, even though you don't care about them, so it doesn't work, but there is a character at every location, and it does like make sense as a final act. Whereas this is just, there's a big fight, I guess. Fall down that hole. It's just bewildering, because I don't care about the droid army, I don't care about the clones, and don't get me started on like the concept of clones. I feel like it's one of the laziest, and like, as someone who enjoys sci-fi, most offensive to me, not in like an offensive sense, I mean like a, I don't know how you could do that as a writer sense. Like, how could you build a universe in which not only are droids apparently sentient life forms, but they're fighting a bunch of fully sentient and human clones, and that's just okay with everyone? Great, good. Like, to come up with a concept like that and ignore the ethics of it is, like, irresponsible as a writer to me. If you're gonna, like, come up with these fictional settings that... Yeah, it's gonna break, isn't it? You're gonna break, you're gonna lose it. That engage in all these concepts, like cloning and artificial intelligence and everything, you have a responsibility to do so, you know, like, honestly. I don't think it's honest to just use them as a backdrop for the ridiculous war and then treat these alive things as disposable. Done. Good. Great. One more run. Like, I'm sure it comes up in the novels a bunch, and it kind of comes up in some of the games, like Republic Commando and Battlefront, where you play as clones, get you into the minds of these soldiers. Just how stunningly awful and inhumane a decision it is to raise an army from birth and to raise an army from birth and just have it, you know, fight for you and have everything. Oh, this level is so terrible. And treat it as disposable, and then like frame it for the kids and everything, the people watching. Frame it as disposable for them as well. Like, at no point am I, as a child who watches Star Wars, expected to care about the lives of the clones. They are treated as a disposable army. Yoda treats them as a disposable army. Obi-Wan treats them as a disposable army. Despite the fact that, like, they have personalities. In Episode 3, Commander Cody is a character, and everyone's like, okay, thanks, Cody. And you know them. And then Cody turns on him when shit goes down. What do I need to do? Oh, I do just destroy those. Okay, cool, great, cool. Ah, come on, come on. Oh, these levels are so bad. And that worked just fine. Now we know what we're doing, we should be okay. Where are we? There we are. Still have the power up. How long are we going to have the power up for? Not much longer, I don't think. Yeah, we're gone. But I shouldn't have to cross the power lines any longer. One more. This battlefield feels so empty now that I've done everything. And it's going to be annoying I didn't get to Jedi if that's how far I've got with all the times I've died. Oh well. We did it. Whee! Goodbye. Dooku's peacing out of here. Well, I guess that's the end of that level. The short one. It took me way longer than it should because of these terrible, terrible sequences with the dragging the bombs, but we're good now. Yeah, 89%. Good. The Battle of Geonosis, though, I've played that in about 1,000 games. Like Republic Commando, Battlefront, this. It must have been other. I haven't played Empire at War, but I bet it's like a mod there. I don't know. But this big event, like, the Death Star blowing up is a thing because it's that in the movie, whereas there are so many set pieces in the prequel trilogy that are clearly created to be iconic before they actually happened. It, like, said, this is a moment, and this is going to be a thing that is replicated again and again and again in all the spin-off media. And that feels so dishonest to me, but that just defines the prequel trilogy, I guess. How do you make a bunch of clones and... It's clear that I'm a Star Trek person or like a Doctor Who person. Well, specifically Russell T. Davies era Doctor Who person. I just want people to discuss the ethics of things. And not in a Gamergate way. Fuck off with that, like, legitimately. If you're gonna have a sci-fi premise, I want you to sit around and talk about it and discuss why it is or isn't a good idea and come to some conclusion. Talk through your shit. I would have loved if the third Star Wars movie was just a complete negotiations politics movie. God, it would have been amazing. If I ever do a big series of space operas, I promise you there'll be the war will start, the big rebellion war would start, and then the next movie would be a long, like, political storyline as they try to end the war that way. That's what I'd do. But no one's hired me, so you'll never know. But it'd be really good, I promise you. There wouldn't be any clones.